guys, I am here with Jonathan Reinig, who just won the Armada Championships. I guess it's a championship. It was the round five, so it was like the top table.
Yeah.
You guys didn't do a cut because it's like a big game.
The time length realistically prohibits from doing any serious cut or anything like that.
But all that said, it's a world championship nonetheless. Yeah. And you came out on top, so congratulations for that. The first thing I want to ask is, Armada's a new game.
Yeah.
Of like the games here, it's one of the newer ones. What is it about Armada that got you excited, that made you want to play this game?
The very first thing was definitely whenever I saw, like, just literally saw the Victory Star Destroyer.
Yeah.
The Imperial Star Destroyer has always been a bit of a fan favorite for me.
Mm-hmm.
Love the Falcon, love Han, that's great. But when it comes to, like, really awesome, cool toys that you might like, that's where my heart hit. And I like the larger scale, more is it tactical or
complex,
strategic?
Strategic. It's
yeah.
more of a strategic game.
Strategic game, less tactical.
Yeah.
Right. So that's where you have a big plan that you're trying to have come together in a game. So
well, I saw you in the top 16 of X-Wing as well.
Yeah.
Another Star Wars space game. So you started out, I presume, in X-Wing, and then kind of migrated to Armada. What was that process like? Why'd you make the switch?
I made the switch mostly just because I was looking for that larger skirmish to kind of fulfill. I played 40K originally.
Yeah.
And so the whole six-turn thing was an easy, smooth transition for me.
Yeah.
So much so as I didn't have a lot of people to play with originally. I actually bought four of my friends' starters.
Cool.
So that I just kind of created a playgroup in the process.
That's a great strategy.
But yeah, no, it was awesome. So.
Well, tell us about your list. Let's talk about Armada. Tell us about what is it that your list did that no one else did, or specifically maybe you as a pilot. What were the key things that led to your victory?
Well, the first thing was there's a giant paper, rock, scissors in the game right now. Where if you take a lot of fighters, then generally speaking, you lose to a few really good fighters.
Okay.
And if you take no fighters, then generally speaking, you beat the few really good fighters. If you take a lot of fighters, then it's usually a happy day when your opponent has none. And I think out of all five rounds I played against one player who brought two fighter squadrons, which wasn't enough to handle eight A-Wings necessarily, but...
So you were doing a ton of fighters.
Yeah, no, I eight A-Wing squads, basically, so that was the game plan. It worked out all right.
Well, run down the list for us. What was the full point spread? Where'd you spend all those points?
Basically, I ran two of the cheaper assault frigates. I think it's like the Mark IIB or whatever. The 72.1. I just ran two of them naked. They're basically just active, like squadron activations. And then I had one CR-90 that I put my commander on, Garm, who's basically an objective runner for those objectives. If I play intel sweeper, stuff like that. So, and then I had the eight A-wings, which I used the two assault frigates to basically activate the A-wing squadrons.
Oh man, how cool is that?
Yeah.
What was the tournament like? Tell us about. So you played five rounds
across
2 days.
Yeah.
And we're talking like 2.5 hour big rounds.
Yeah.
So how was it?
2 hours right now. They'll move to 2.5 whenever they get to 400. But it was weird too. At home in the local community, most of our games finish in about an hour.
Wow.
Which is, I guess, impressive because almost all my games here went really long. I think the last one was the one I didn't finish within 5 minutes of time being called.
Wow.
So that was kind of an interesting transition between what I'm used to playing and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And now I've rambled. I've forgotten the original question.
Well, was there any squads that you faced off against that you
were
like, oh, no?
Definitely. There was a mirror match. I was up against the two assault frigates and a CR-90, and he had two X-Wings.
Oh, wow.
And I'm like, well, crap, because he can... I went into the tournament game planning to play gladiators all day, because gladiators want to get up and close, so then you can maintain your squadron medium distance, and then you can just kind of skirt the long range with him for a couple turns, and you can take them as they come in one at a time. That's fine. If you're playing against opposing assault frigates, then whenever you go to activate your squadrons, assault frigates love long range. They've got the evade token, they're having a great time. So at that point, you're broadsiding each other at long range, and to attack with your squadrons, you have to overextend them to where you can't activate them on the next turn.
Right, okay. Okay.
So that was probably, I had no idea how I was supposed to win that match. And then when it was said and done, it just kind of came out in my favor. It was a 6-4 win, so it was really close.
Well, what would you tell aspiring Armada players out there, now that you're here, you've done the thing, you've won what is the first world championship for Armada. What about everyone out there watching who either isn't into this game yet or they're into it but they can't quite figure out how to be successful?
The biggest thing I can say is pay attention to the meta, but don't be the meta. Like, everyone practices against the meta list. Like, everyone came to this event practicing against the, I guess everybody's calling it the Gen Con special or whatever.
Okay.
The
yeah.
Three Glads and a Vic. Everybody practiced against that. And then the second that you put, I put A-Wings down on the board, they're like, I have no idea how this is going to work. I don't know what's going to happen. So don't worry about the meta so much. Be aware of it. Practice against it. But just definitely do something different, because that changing what someone's used to playing against can sometimes just be the matter, especially in a close game like Armada. It can be the difference between winning and losing. So.
Well, excellent, Jonathan. Thank you so much.
Excellent.
Congratulations. It's been Jonathan Reinig. He is the first ever Armada World Champion, and we got more coming from Worlds 2015. Stay tuned, guys. Thanks so much.